What's up, guys? My name is Carrie. I'm a psycho-spiritual wellness coach, and this is my first vlog, and what I'm going to be talking about is how to do a binge right. I might lose some of you because I know that a lot of people come here trying to stop binge eating, but I'm going to talk about what to do if you are going to binge. Most of us know when we're going to binge. And I think that there is a certain way that you can go about it that will prevent it from happening more. And if you use this practice, I think you can get it to happen less and less. And I also think that this can minimize how much you binge. So I'm not exactly trying to encourage you to binge eat. Rather, I want to help you learn what to do if you know you're gonna binge no matter what. So this is a super casual video. I'm going to talk a lot because I just want to. I just came back from the gym and I hope I don't look too disgusting. The reason why I wanted to make this video is because the last time I had a very serious binge was about a year and a half ago, and I wrote a very vulnerable piece on that, which I will link below. It's one of my most popular articles because I kind of, I'm really vulnerable in that post, and I talk about how even though I am a coach that helps women stop overeating, I still struggle with it myself. And I haven't really had that happen for a year and a half. But recently, I went through some hardship in my life, and I really wanted sweets. So this is what the process looked like for me, and I'm sharing this so that hopefully you can mimic this, and then I'll explain why this is helpful later. Next. So what I did was it was 8 p.m. or 7 p.m. and I just really wanted sweets. And so what I did was I set a timer for 4 minutes, and I did the stop, drop, and feel. If you already have the space to stop yourself before a binge, if you can create space before your binge, always do the stop, drop, and feel. Because what that does is it lets you make space for the feelings that are driving the desire to binge eat. And most of the time, it will take away the pull of the food, because those feelings will lose their edge once you make space for them. Now, sometimes the stop, drop, and feel doesn't work. And when my timer went up after 4 minutes, and the reason why I picked 4 minutes was just because that's how long I felt like I could do it. I'll usually pick anywhere between 2 to 10 minutes, depending on how tolerant I'm feeling. So after my 4 minutes timer went up, I still freaking wanted sweets. So what I did, and this just makes me smile, is I went to Target and I milled around looking for exactly what appealed to me, because I wanted to, if I was gonna binge, I wanted to do it right. So what I ended up buying was Oreo pistachio thins, blackberries, grapes, and Sour Patch Kids, because that is what I wanted. And so when I got home, I took out my super fun little bowls. I got these from Costco. I don't know if there's a Costco in your area, but I filled each little bowl, 4 of these bowls, with my little goodies. And then I sat on my bed because that was just where I wanted to be, and I did not turn on Netflix or anything. I just let myself freaking enjoy all of this sugar. And I ate everything in all of the bowls. I wasn't super stuffed after, but I do consider it a binge because I wasn't hungry when it happened. Now, why would I encourage you to eat when you're not hungry like this? The reason why I thought it was really awesome that I got the little bowls involved is because those bowls are awesome, they're adorable, and they bring me a lot of joy. And one reason why we compulsively eat is because we're seeking pleasure, we're seeking joy from food, because there probably isn't enough joy in our lives. This is called hedonic eating, and I will link to an article on hedonic eating below. So if that resonates with you, if you feel like when your life is just feeling really drab, you find yourself reaching for food in those moments, that's probably hedonic eating. And ideally, you want to be adding joy outside of food into your life to get over hedonic eating. But if you're going to binge, like if you know you're going to binge, you might as well make it extra fun. Make it fun. I know that we hate doing this. Like, I know what it's like to be in the grips of compulsive eating, wishing that you just weren't doing it, but still doing it anyway. But if you're gonna do it, just let yourself do it and have fun with it. The other reason why I'm encouraging you to do this is because when you give yourself permission to have whatever foods you want, those foods lose their pull. If I had gone to Target and bought a package of Oreo pistachio thins, and then I came home and I tried to just like only have two or just like try and resist it, I probably would have eaten the whole thing. But because I was allowing myself to have however much I want, because I gave up dieting like 2 or 3 years ago, it loses its magnetic pull. I know that I can have this anytime that I want, so now I just kind of don't really want it. I don't really eat sweets that much these days, but when I do, I make sure I let myself have it. Another reason why I think it's okay to let yourself binge when you already know you're gonna binge is because by allowing yourself to do it, you're going to end up eating less. It's the lack of permission. It is the restriction that causes the binge. Like there are two causes of binge eating. One is the emotions that we don't want to feel. And the other is the restriction. When we don't let ourselves have the food that we want it even more. So even though I'm like kind of encouraging you to, if you're gonna binge, do it right, I do think that this will help you in the long run, because this will help you learn how to give yourself permission to do what you're already gonna do. And as you slowly open up and get over the fear of allowing yourself to have whatever you want, it will lose its magnetic pull and you'll be able to eat normal portions of these things. Like, even though this was a binge for me because I wasn't hungry, I don't think I ate an absurd amount of food. I think I ate an absurd amount of sugar, that's for sure. But I don't think I ate an absurd amount of food. And I am the same size today as I was 2 weeks ago, as I was 2 months ago. So I just, if you're watching this video and you're afraid that following this advice is going to make you gain weight, I think that this will help you achieve your natural weight in the long run. So I hope this is helpful for you. I know that this video is going to be the most helpful for people who have that space in between them and their binge where they can kind of think it through and take positive action, like what I described here. If you find yourself in a position where the eating is too compulsive and you don't have like the time or self-control to go out to Target and get exactly what appeals to you, and you don't have the patience to put it in pretty little bowls, you just find yourself compulsively eating like in front of the fridge or in front of the pantry, this practice will be more helpful for you as you progress in your journey. I guess this is kind of like an advanced video, because this video, these tips are the most helpful for someone who has already created that space between them and their binges. If you struggle with extremely compulsive eating and unconscious eating, where you're in the kitchen before you know it, the binge has passed before you've realized it, this isn't going to be the most helpful. And just so that I don't leave you hanging, what I would recommend is focusing 100% only on the stop, drop, and feel. I have a whole other video on it, which I think I will link above and below. And do the stop, drop, and feel all day long. So when we do the stop, drop, and feel before we binge, you're building emotional tolerance, right? You are training in being uncomfortable or whatever that feeling is for you. So for example, if you really struggle with loneliness and you do the stop, drop, and feel, and that's the feeling that comes up, training in feeling lonely will help you increase your ability to feel lonely, but not get swept away by it, but not feel compelled to numb that feeling with food. When you do the stop, drop, and feel when you're not triggered all throughout the day, that helps you develop emotional awareness. So let's say you're at your 9-to-5 job and you're sitting at your desk, and you can think to yourself, oh, what am I feeling? I'm gonna do the stop, drop, and feel right now. And you just kind of tune in and ask yourself, what are you feeling? And then let it bubble up. Maybe you can name it, maybe you can't, but this is how you develop emotional awareness, and you need a certain level of emotional awareness before you can develop emotional tolerance. So I hope that all of this makes sense. If you have any questions, leave them for me below. I also recommend signing up for my free ebook below. And once you get onto my email list, you can hit respond to any of my emails to get in touch with me directly. I'm happy to help. I am a coach after all. And I hope you enjoyed this vlog. I don't really know how this is gonna turn out because I just came back from the gym. I don't feel totally disgusting, but I always end up filming these videos when I'm fresh out of the gym and sweaty, or fresh out of the shower with wet hair. I just, I'm not very inspired when I get ready. I just do these when I am feeling inspired, so. All right, guys, I am signing off. If you like this video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. I post new content very randomly, so if you don't subscribe, you'll miss out. All right, I'll see you guys next time.